in terms of overall impact, I think there is a trust deficit. There is an absence of trust or a lack of trust between the major players here. So when you are talking of real money, big money, that isn't there. When you are talking of big commitment, that we have not heard yet. Everybody is saying we must do something, and not many governments or heads of government know what is this something is. Now, something is a combination of a package of rapid reduction in greenhouse gas by the industrialized countries first. Subsequently, over a period, the leading developing countries in transition, rapidly, those are economic transition, they will do that. But they have no legal obligation at this point in time. That is the language of the climate convention, but that is going to be modified, and some people are trying to do it, particularly in the United States. That is not going down kindly. The third is the whole issue of how much money is on the table for adaptation and for mitigation. Then who can get it, who can't get it. US is very hung up, that China may not be, or big country like that may not get anything. That is not liked very much. There's a whole question of monitoring of regimes that has not been discussed at all. So large number of complex issues are on the table. Time is very, very short. We have 1.5 days, literally, unless all our heads of government are willing to spend all of night of Friday doing this. My own feeling is, as President Obama comes in on the 18th, the dynamics will shift to an extent. Time will be very short. There will be some sort of convergence. But when that sort of convergence happens at the last minute, one of the tragedies that happens at the lowest common denominator. So everything goes down, scales down into expectation, and that becomes not very fortunate for the planet. Sadly, most of these governments or heads of governments are looking at the whole problem from their own little eyes. Definitely the United States is doing so. So are major developing countries. Europe likewise. The question is a global problem, needs global solutions, needs global leadership. Sadly, our leaders are pathetic at this point in time, if not, you know, empty people in their own terms. They are not serving the interest of their own people. They are serving the interest of a small elite of their respective countries. And this elite are the rich, the policymakers, those who are beneficiary of the greenhouse gas of the 200 years accumulation. They are serving that cause and not the cause of the global people and the global commons.
You are here as an NGO representative. Now restrictions have been imposed on NGOs.
Well, access. I am an NGO. I'm representing the government here. But there's been huge process failure in the management of how do you enter people. If somebody has registered, then somebody has the right to come in. Now that right has been infringed upon. I was standing there for 3.5 hours. I had two of my colleagues standing there. They had to go back after 3 hours of waiting in the snow or in the bitter cold. Now, this management has been not very good. I totally understand that they are trying to look after the security of everybody. I sympathize that. I respect that position. But security management is one thing, and rights infringement is quite another. And they are not to be confused. Now,